You mentioned Twitter, and it got a laugh, but actually, you are incredibly active on the Twitters.
I love Twittering.
What do you love about the platform?
It's you're talking to people. I can't go anyplace anymore. I walk around a block. That's about it. Can't get in a plane anymore because most of the cities you come to, my bed isn't there. My bed is on Rodeo Drive, and so I'm a stick in the mud. I have one good friend, Mel Brooks, who comes over every night. We watch television.
Mel who?
Mel Brooks. Brooks.
Short. I've heard of that fellow. Yeah.
Short,
yeah.
Short Jewish man.
Yeah.
Yes, the 2,000-year-old man. That was an interesting story. I met Mel when he was about 21 years old. I was about 25. He was a friend of Sid Caesar's, not working on the show, and he came to visit once. And the first day I was there, this man stands up and he starts to say he was a pirate, a Jewish pirate. And I'll never forget the first lines. He says, "You know," he says, "I can't set sail anymore. I can't afford to set sail." He says, "You know what they're charging for sailcloth? $4 a yard. I can't afford to pillage and rape anymore." The first words I heard from him. And then,
the first words out of Mel Brooks' mouth.
Yes. And the following day, I came in. There was a program called We the People Speak. And I said, "That's a good program to satirize." And I said to Mel, "Here's a man who was actually at the scene of the crucifixion 2,000 years ago. Is that true, sir?" And he went, "Oh, boy." I says, "You knew Jesus?" He says, "Thin lad, right?" He walked around with 12 other guys, sandals they wore. He says, "They came into the store all the time, asked for water. I gave it to them. They were nice guys, never bought anything." That was the first line.
That was the beginning of it.
And then for the next 10 years, at parties, when it was dull anywhere, we'd get up and do it. And it took 10 years to get it on record.
And then it blew up.
Yes, it blew.
Hey, thanks for watching.
Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and click here for more videos.
And make sure to catch new episodes Friday at 9 p.m. on HuffingtonPost.com.